What's up, groovy people? This is Dannic, and you're watching Frame of Fame. Yeah, this was definitely in China. This was, I think it was in Guangzhou. Or Changsha, but of course within the Panda Park. And yeah, I was trying to do the same like ballet thing that this panda was doing, and I almost like hurt my sprained my hamstring. Seriously, it happened. No, I haven't seen the movie Kung Fu Panda, but I wish I had seen it, because this park was all about that. But back in the days, I was really into Disney movies. I think I watched all the Disney movies in my life. And yeah, right now, I really want to see Lion King first, and then maybe Kung Fu Panda. Yes. Well, this is definitely a photo in, I think it's Japan. This was maybe the look of my face. I'm super young here, maybe 5 years ago. One of the first times I went to Japan. And I was really blown away. They waited for me at the airport. One of the first times that I saw so many fans at the airport. There were more behind this photo. Yeah, this is so heartwarming. Every time I come to a new country, or I come again to a country and I see fans, it really warms my heart, and it's amazing. And they made this flag with "Don't panic, listen to Dannic." Yeah. What else? Yes, luckily I have a lot of fans that are really dedicated, and I'm really happy with that, because it's always nice, they always bring me presents. And last time I went to, what was it? I went to, Vietnam. I think I had like a full bag of gifts with me back home to Amsterdam. It's crazy. The craziest gift. I get many crazy gifts, but I have a whole Pokemon collection now because of my fans, which is crazy. And what else? Yeah, I once had like a signed photo of a fan, but he signed it itself. So I got a present from him with his face, and it's now on my office. Yeah, this is in Thailand, in Phuket. We were there we had a show on Wednesday, and then we had 2 days off, and we wanted to see some elephants. And we rented a scooter, almost got ourselves killed, because it's super dangerous there with scooter. They go like 100 kilometers an hour, and yeah, it's sick. And the roads were like rainy, so it was really, really slippery there. And then we saw some elephant signs. We went there, and yeah, this is the picture I took. And they told us that these are not, these are like taken care of. They're not doing any hard work. They're not like, how do you say it? They look healthy, but I don't know if it's true. Of course, I can check that. But it's always like, it's really crazy, because you still see he's being held there. So it's mixed feelings about this picture, but yeah, in the end it was funny because he looked in the camera and it was like a selfie with an elephant. My favorite animal has to be a hamster. We had a hamster like, I think, 10 years ago, and those animals are crazy. The hamster once jumped into the Christmas tree, fell down with the whole Christmas tree, and like there was complete chaos, and then he was sitting there just eating a carrot. Just kind of laughing at us. It was crazy. What is this? Huh? Is this the first picture I ever posted on Instagram? What was I thinking? Oh, this is crazy. Probably I didn't even have an artist page at that time. It was just my first. Are there any pictures that I posted and regret it? Yeah, probably. Sometimes, because I, of course, everyone likes to show the most amazing life, but sometimes I do post pictures where I look like completely tired, because sometimes I am tired. And it is what it is. So sometimes I post a picture and then my mom sends me a text like, are you okay? You look so tired on this picture. I'm like, okay, yeah, but it is what it is, right? You can always post nice photos. And I like to see, to show the real life. That's what I do in my videos as well. So yeah, I do. This is actually a funny picture. I took it on It's the Ship, a boat party. We were there for 4 days on a boat. And yeah, they had big balloons and smileys all over the place. And I took this smiley and put it on my face. And this is actually my favorite smiley. I think yesterday was World Smiley Day. And this is my favorite smiley that I use a lot. I think it's number one when you type in something. So yeah, and that's basically just, you know, take life with a smile. That's basically it. Not too serious. The funniest gig I performed at? So many. I had some shows where I started kind of as Dannic and then ended up playing like domestic music and all kinds of stuff. I played 50 Cent and it was just because the crowd was like it and I played for 3 hours instead of 1 hour. I think it was in... it was during the bus tour with Hard One Dyro. Yes, we had a PlayStation on the bus. Obviously, when we were touring that much, you need to do something besides music, and there was a PlayStation. So we did a Call of Duty tournament for the whole tour, and I think I lost big time because I never played it in my life. So I started there, and I think Dyro was instantly like he killed me every time I was even there. Like I was dead. And Hardwell was he was not too bad, but I sucked. I was really bad. Ah, yes. I was really happy when we took this picture because Axwell, Alesso, one of my all-time heroes for sure. When I started producing, like Axwell was my guy that I was listening to all the time. Especially with the Swedish House Mafia at the time, and the way they mixed in that kick drum and stuff, that's something that I worked on tons of hours just to get that same result. And this was in Miami. I was there with Hardwell, of course, as you can see. We were there having a drink. It was during WMC in 2012 or 13. We look really young, so. And then we're at Liv, and Harold was saying like, oh, we should take a photo. And I was like, no, I was too starstruck. But he said, yeah, come in the booth. So I took a beer, as you can see. Get some courage in there, and we took a picture. Yeah, because when we did the bus tour, obviously three of us, and it was really similar to the Swedish House Mafia. So our fans, and especially the fans of Hardwell, were starting to call us the Dutch House Mafia, just because it was funny. There were three of us, and we were touring together. And sometimes we ended up with the three of us playing back to back to back on the stage. And we had so much fun. And of course, we did some collabs together. And yeah, like for instance, I had a Hardwell and Dannic collab, and then Dyro did the remix, and vice versa. So that's what it came about. But there's still a lot of people that want us to come back as the Dutch House Mafia, so maybe, who knows. All right, guys, this is it. My name is Dannic. Thanks so much to Heldeep for having me. This was Frame of Fame, and don't forget to subscribe here.